From Belluno, from the region of Venice, and exactly from the Dolomiti Mountains.
And as we understand the program, as I'm going to tell them about it, is about Stenliden and Stenhammar. I did understand that you somehow were interested in romance or Swedish romance music from early age.
Yes, that happens because one evening, several years ago, I was at home and I was listening to the radio in Italy, and they have transmitted a song by Tore Rangström. And for me, it was strange because I have never known him before, that name. And I am very curious by nature, and so I have tried to get quite more familiar with that music. And from then I have discovered more, and I love very much the music of Sweden.
That's lovely. I'm so happy for that. And you never know what can happen in the future now when we are two romantic personalities with our music in Swedish 1800, blah, blah, blah. But we also have your friend here, Jonathan Östlund. And there is also something interesting because you have made something with him in, or your wife and you, or your girlfriend, or whatever. She plays the
saxophone.
Saxophone.
Classical saxophone.
And you have made a piece somewhere in Europe with
In
that music.
Germany,
In Germany, yes. So that is also going to be exciting to hear this world premiere tonight with his music that he heard just some minutes ago, actually, at the rehearsal. You the first time heard your piece because you didn't hear any other pianist do it, so it was really exciting. So what I would like to say is that, you know, you're mostly welcome, and I know you start with Stenhammar, Sensommarnätter, which is of course perfect in this heat and also in this late summer. It is Opus 33, and I am sure that Jakob, if I asked him,
Pixie.
Knows Pixie knows a lot about this as well. But you will start, and I think that you together will make the music. If you sit down, I will tell them what sort of music there will be. I will talk with you later. The first piece, as we don't have programs, unfortunately, is Tranquillo e Suave. Suave?
Suave.
Suave, and that means very slowly and
slowly and
tranquille. So it's very, yes, so it starts like that. And then it's poco presto. And that goes a little bit faster.
Not so fast.
Not so fast, but a little, yeah. And then it's non troppo lento. Piccio? Pico?
Piano.
Piano non troppo lento. I need stronger glasses, obviously. And that is not so fast, or it means that lento?
Not too much slow.
Not too
Longsat.
much slow. It n doesn't go too slow. And then it's presto agitato. And
that
that
is
is very fast. Well, you know, we have to know how fast everything will go. It doesn't say anything actually about the pieces. Poco allegretto comes after that. And then I would say like this, if you are interested to know more about Stenhammar, Sensommarnätter, just go in to Schepparkarl's site, which is called Schepparkarl Salon, and we have written, or you have written everything about it. Silenzio, Maria Baczynska. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
something like this, you just are humble and you say it's a lot of work in the piano and solfeggio is very important when you're small. I heard both you and Pixie says. I would like to just say thank you also that your mother is watching. Paola is her name. You're watching this from, perhaps you have turned it off, I'm sorry.
No, no, it's on.
It's on, in Toscana, she's watching you, and she should be so proud of something so beautiful, to have something like this, a son who is going so deep and doing it so beautiful, and I'm sure that Jakob also thinks so, and Pixie's actually crying. So, you wait a little bit, and
yep.
I will sing a piece with Pixie, as he calls himself nowadays. And you wait and relax and have a good time. And after that, I have done this with Pixie. Then we will listen to Östlund, and I will tell a little bit more about that. But we are now doing something that is unfortunately in yeah, but you know, the film camera will go on, you know.
It's a bit wet.
Sorry?
Wet
there.